Hello everybody and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today we're going to be creating mist in Blender. We're going to be using the smoke simulation and a fancy material to get this effect. Let's first start out by grabbing our cube and then pressing X and deleting it. Then you can press Shift A and we're going to go to Mesh and then Circle right here. With this circle, I'm going to go into Edit Mode, press E to extrude, then right click. Then I'm going to scale it inwards just a little bit, then I'm going to hit F and that will create a face in the middle. Next, I'm going to press A once or twice to make sure everything is selected, then press E to extrude and drag it down. After you've done that, you can go into face select mode by clicking on this button down here. Holding down the Alt key, you can right click on that edge, and then press E to extrude and drag it up. Next, go underneath, right click on this edge, Alt right click, and then press extrude and drag it down. So we're going to have a little circle right here to emit smoke, and it will flow over the side and then onto the ground. So what we need to do next is right click on this middle face, press Shift D, then right click and it will snap it to wherever it's at. Then you can hit P and go Selection. So now we have two different objects. We have this one and then this one right here. Now right click on this face and then drag it upwards and then scale it in, just so that there's a little bit of a gap in between this main circle and then the smaller one. You can go into Edit Mode, right click on it and extrude it upwards to give it some thickness. There we go, not too bad. Okay, now let's right click on them and drag them up to the grid. Okay, so now with this object selected, we can go down to Object, Quick Effects, and then Quick Smoke. And that will automatically create a domain for us with the material already in place. This will save us some time later. Next, go into Top View, then press 5 to go into Orthographic View. We're going to scale this up. So press S, Shift Z, and then drag it outwards. Doing Shift Z will only scale it along the Y and the X axis, and that is what I want. Okay, so now let's see what happens if we play this. So I'm going to hit Alt A, and you'll notice that the smoke is going up, but it's not looking like mist at all. So what we need to do with our circle selected, go down to the physics settings over here on the right, change the surface value to 1. Basically, that just makes it so that only where the surface area is will emit smoke. We can leave the density at 1. The temperature difference is what we need to change. Right now it's set to a positive value, so that means that the temperature will rise, the smoke will rise. We need to set this to a negative value, so the smoke is colder, so it will fall down. So now, if we play this, let's hit Alt A, you'll notice that the smoke is now falling down, which is good. I'm also going to set the color to white, then turn on initial velocity. Let's see what this looks like now. Not too bad. It's looking a little bit better, but it's still not quite right. So I'm going to select this object because I want it to collide with it. So with it selected, click on Smoke and select Collision. The collision type, it doesn't really matter, but I found that Animated is a little bit better. It's just a little bit more accurate, so you can change it to Animated. Now let's go to the domain. The first thing that we want to change is the border collisions. Right now it's set to open, so basically what that means is that once the smoke hits the border of the domain, it will just pass through it. There's no collision, so we need to change this to collide all, and that will collide with all the edges of the domain. Let's play this and see what it looks like. There you go. You notice that the smoke is going over the top and then falling down, which is great. Now the resolution right here, the higher you turn this to, it will look a little bit different the more you mess with this setting. Once we do a final bake, I'm going to set it to 90, but for now, I'm going to set it to 64. This will make the smoke look a little bit better. Hold on, we need to restart and play it. There we go. That's looking pretty good. The vorticity, this is the amount of swirls in the smoke. I'm going to set that to a value of 1. So it's a little bit more smooth. I'll play it one more time. There we go. Okay, now let's open up the smoke adaptive domain. If we turn this on, you'll notice that there's a box now that appears on our smoke. Basically, what this is doing is only calculating where the smoke is in the domain. With this unchecked, it's calculating this whole entire cube. We don't need that to happen since the smoke is already in a small area. So we're leaving all of this extra space to be not baked in. That will save memory and render time. So make sure that's turned on. The next setting that we're going to discuss is the smoke high resolution. What this will do is it will make your smoke look a lot better. If I play this, you'll notice that it's looking already really good. Once we do a final bake, we'll turn this up to maybe 3. So the differences between the divisions down here and the divisions up here, this one will only make your smoke look better. This one will affect how it behaves. I think it adds more like voxels. That's how the resolution is calculated in voxels. It adds more voxels, and so it makes it a little bit different. But this will not affect your simulation at all. It will only affect how it looks. So once you find a good resolution up here, make sure you turn this up to a higher value to make it look good. The noise right here, I'm going to set that to 0 because I don't want there to be any noise. I want it to be smooth. So now let's play this one more time and see what it looks like. There we go. Not too bad. Actually, I want it to go over the top a little bit faster, so I'm going to select this object, hold Alt, right click on that edge, and just drag it downwards. There we go. So now if we play this, now it's going over the edge a little bit faster. Okay, perfect. So now let's right click on the domain, and I think we're good to go with the baking, but if we open up the cache, you'll notice that it's grayed out. The reason for this is because we haven't saved our project yet, so make sure you hit Control S to save it. I'm just going to save it to, there it is, Miss Tutorial. Tutorial 4, since I've already tried to record this a couple times and my mic was not working very well. Okay, so now that we've done that, we can set the end frame. Let's figure out where we want to set the end frame, so let's play this. And once it reaches probably 150, I think we'll be good. Yeah, probably around there I think we'll be fine. So let's set the end frame to like 160. Also go into front view, and it looks like we need to drag our domain down, so just make sure the bottom face is selected right here, and then go into front view and drag it underneath where our cylinder is. Okay, there we go. We need to restart the animation, and there it is. Okay, so now that we've done that, let's play it one more time to make sure everything looks good. Hold on, restart it. There we go. Not too bad. So I think 160 will be fine. One more thing I want to add into the scene is a turbulence force field, just to give it some more variation. So I'm going to press Shift C to snap my cursor to the center, press Shift A, go to force field, and then turbulence. And we can leave it probably in the middle of the scene will be fine. Now the strength right here, this is a little strong, so I'm going to set it to 0.4, maybe even 0.35. I think that'll be good. The noise, I'm going to turn that up to 1. So now we are ready to bake. So make sure your divisions is set to 90 and your smoke high resolution is set to 3 or 4, whatever you want. I'm going to go with 3, then hit bake. Okay, the baking has finished and this is our result. We can scroll through here and find a frame that we like. So let's go with something like that. So there we go, that looks pretty cool. Okay, so now let's do the lighting for our scene before we do the materials. So for the lighting, I'm going to delete this lamp up here, so you can select it, then press X and delete it. Then you can press Shift A, go to Mesh, and then Plane. You can drag this plane above the domain, probably around there, and then scale it up, maybe about that size. And this is going to be an emission just pointing straight down on our smoke. So go over to the Material tab and click New. Change the surface to Emission, and you can set the color to a value, or a color of probably around there, a little bit bluish. I think that'll be good. Then the strength you can set to a value of 4. Next, press Shift A, add in a plane, and this is going to be the ground. So scale this up by pressing S, then typing 100, and enter. This is just going to be a principled shader, just so it adds some glossiness to the whole scene. So add in a new material, select here, and go principled. The roughness we can bring up just a little bit, probably around to 0.1. I think that'll be good. For this cylinder right here, it can be that same material, so make sure you name this one. We'll just type in glossy. Then select the cylinder, click on the drop-down menu, and select glossy. Perfect. Now let's position the camera. So I'm going to position it probably around here, hit Ctrl+Alt+0 to snap it into place. Then you can right-click on it, and then press G, middle mouse button, and drag it backwards. Probably around here I think will be a good shot. Let's find a frame. Maybe bring it this way just a little bit, zoom in. There we go. Something like that I think will be good. Alright, let's press Shift-Z and see what it looks like. Not too bad. You can also change the world settings to black. So if you go over to the world settings, it's very slow right now. Make sure it's set to black. Okay, so for our flow object, we're going to create a simple ice material with a noise texture and some displacement. So go over to the material tab and click on new. We can call this material ice, and then we'll open up the node editor. So just drag, drag it outwards just like this and come down to the node editor. Okay, so first off, we're going to delete the diffuse shader, then press Shift A, we're going to add in a shader, and then glass shader. You can take the output and plug it into the surface. Then the IOR, this is just basically how light passes through a glass and how it distorts it. We're going to set this value to 1.85. Pretty high, and you can see it's pretty distorted. You can also change the color to just a slight blue, somewhere around there, I think will be good. Next, add in a noise texture by going to texture and then noise texture right here. Take the color and plug it into the displacement. Then set the scale to a value of 15, maybe 20. We'll see what it looks like. That's pretty cool. The detail, we can turn that up to 3 and the distort up to 1. There we go. So we have a nice ice looking material. We can also control how much the displacement is affecting it by adding in a math node, setting it to multiply, and plugging that in between the noise texture and the displacement. This value right here now controls how strong it will be. So if you want less, you can turn it down. You can see it's a lot more smooth. If you want it like crazy, you can turn it up. I think a value of like 0.6, I think is fine. A little bit displacement, maybe 0.7. Yeah, let's go with 0.7. All right, so there we go. There's our ice material. Very simple. Okay, so for the smoke material, let's select it, then open up the node editor. So drag a window out, scroll down here, and click on node editor. All right, so this is the material for our smoke. We have a volume absorption with a volume scatter combined with an add shader. Here we have the multiply node. This is the density of the smoke, and this value right here controls that. We can see the density is going into it. The color attribute right here, since we set the color in the flow setting to white, it should try to be white, but it's not going to work that great. It's still sort of dark and gray. To fix this, we're going to be adding in a couple more nodes to get that white color. With this add shader right here, this allows us to easily plug in whatever nodes that we want. Normally this is for fire, but since we're not using fire, we can use it for our light material. So press Shift A, we're going to add in a shader and then emission shader. Next, press Shift A, we're going to add in a transparent shader right here. One more node, press Shift A, we're going to add in a mix shader right here. Take the emission and plug it into the add shader, the bottom input actually, not the top. Then take the transparent and plug it into the top input of the mix shader. Then take the output and plug it into the add shader socket right there. Next, take the color out of the attribute and plug it into the emission. Then take the color and plug it into the transparent. Actually, one more node that we need to add is a light path. So press Shift A, go to input, and then light path right here. Take the is camera ray and plug it into the factor. So what this is doing is it's telling Blender that it needs to emit light, the material needs to emit light, but it's only visible in the camera view. So it's not gonna affect any of the scene. It's not gonna emit a light on the plane or the cylinder. The only place where it's gonna emit light is in the camera view. And that is exactly what we want. So with this emission shader, we can control how bright it will look. Let's press Shift B and draw a box around the camera so it will just run a little bit faster. Then I'll press Shift Z so we can see it. So here it is, and let's actually delete this, or let's hide this plane up here. So select it, then press H. And you'll notice that it's not emitting light anywhere in the scene, it's only in the camera view, which is what we want. The strength right here, we can play around with this. Let's set it to 4, see what that looks like. There we go. You can see it's really starting to look like mist. I think that looks good. I'm going to leave that at 4. Then I'll press Z twice to get rid of that. Then you can press Alt-H to bring back that plane. Okay, I think we are good to go. So let's close off this panel. Let's just make sure everything is good. I think so. So now let's go over to the render settings. First off, I want to make sure the resolution is set to 100, so you can type in 100 right there. Then scroll down to the sampling section. I'm going to set the indirect to a value of 1, and I'm going to set the render samples to a value of 150. I think that'll be good. The light paths we can leave. Everything else I think is fine, so make sure you save your project. Then click on Render. Actually, wait. Before we do that, we need to turn on denoising in the Render Layers panel, then click Render. So save your project one more time and render. Okay, the render has finished and this is our result. I think it looks really nice. You can't really see the ice material though. You might be able to maybe animate the smoke inflow so it stops us at a certain time and then you can see the ice material, but I think it looks good. The smoke looks really nice and white. All right, yeah, so that's gonna be it for this tutorial. Thank you for watching. If you learn something new or create your own image, I'd love to see that. So make sure to send it to me on Twitter or Instagram. Like, comment, and subscribe for more tutorials, and I'll see you guys in the next video.